Nihao, sambalum makan, namaste, assalamualaikum. Noi, my wife, a very good evening to you all. It's indeed an honor for my wife, Sarah, and I to join you for this anniversary banquet. Thank you for the invitation. We thank you most sincerely for your invitation, as it has given us another opportunity to meet and renew the bonds of friendship with many of you. So good to see all faces. In fact, we're most happy to see all of them familiar faces. And being here this evening reminds us of the time and the fun times we had as very active members of the Parents, Teachers and Friends Association of the schools when we used to fundraise for the school's projects, whilst our two sons, Emmanuel and Andrew, whom you've heard, were attending Yetchel's kindergarten, primary and secondary schools. Those were some of the life-changing and very inspirational moments of family. We're also very pleased to see new faces, especially the younger generations, playing a lead role in managing the schools and their affairs. I understand that tonight's dinner is the culmination of a very exciting week of celebrations, beginning on Saturday the 27th of August, with a parade from the flea market in Schooner Park, and continuing over the past few days with an open day, a gala concert, and various other social events organized for the Fiji, Yatsen, and Lumang. Well done, and thank you. I wish to extend both our sincere and hearty congratulations to the Yatsen community on the 80th and 30th anniversary of the Yatsen primary and secondary schools, respectively. The schools have certainly come a long way and have achieved so much for this country. Our family is fortunate to have been associated with schools to our two sons, who are now both commercial pilots, and I'd like to think that they were able to successfully progress with their careers because of the solid academic foundation they received as students of Yatsen schools. There are of course only two of the many thousands of individuals who have gone through the corridors of Yatsen schools and are now contributing meaningfully to Fiji, the other countries that they may have now chosen to call home. I believe that the Yatsen community is continuing to contribute very positively to Fiji's social, economic and cultural development in precisely the same way the government wants all our respective communities to do. That is, for all our communities to collaborate with government in harnessing and cultivating a knowledge-based society through a focus on high-quality education and continuous learning. In this respect, we should all pay homage to the founders of the schools. We owe them a huge gratitude for their decision about 80 years ago, as we heard, by 1936 to be exact, to establish a school for the then Chinese community. Their wish was simple but deeply felt. They wanted to ensure that their children were educated in English, the lingua franca of Fiji, as well as in the Chinese language. They also wanted them to learn and maintain their culture and traditional values and be able to contribute profoundly to society whilst preserving their own cultural heritage and values. I believe that their dreams have been achieved and will continue to be realized by generations to come. I speak from experience when I say that the Yatsen schools are among the top schools in Fiji. Schools continue to be among the higher-end of academic achievements in this country. I'm also very aware of the constant long list of applications from parents who want to secure a place for their child or children. I'm reliably informed that this situation has remained unchanged over these past years because of the school's established and enviable reputation. Such reputation is testimony to the support and commitment of all stakeholders. It's an exceptionally encouraging reflection of the Yatsen community spirit and culture of achieving excellence, and I wish to acknowledge and commend all who have contributed to the ongoing success of the two schools. As President Hayden said, I also acknowledge the vision for the two schools to open their doors to all ethnic communities in Fiji. This initiative may have been introduced several decades ago, but it is yet again another very good example of what Fiji wants and must continue to do. That is to inculcate a greater sense of true friendship perspectives on lasting unity among Fiji's multi-ethnic communities. The new Fiji that we are building is one of unfettered national unity where our children, our grandchildren, future generations know only one human race and how to respect and care for one another. Our young and developing nation will be the ultimate winner if we continue to promote government vision of one nation and one people, a deep sense of pride and oneness, as evidenced by the whole nation when we came together recently to welcome our heroes and celebrate their historic achievement by winning the 7th rugby gold medal in the Rio Olympic Games. I believe the celebration still continues. Ladies and gentlemen, I know that almost all of us here are already very familiar with the history of the two schools, so I do not intend to delve into this tonight. Unless instead I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge once again the founders of the two schools, the Chinese Education Society, and commend and thank all the teachers, management staff and parents, both past and present, and last but not least, our present student body who are continuing to build and uphold the Yat-Shan legacy. I acknowledge and thank all past and present teachers too, their teaching principles well and continue to add significant value to the quality of education and inspiring our students, always reach for greater heights. This has undoubtedly contributed to the quality of life of the students and their respective families. I acknowledge the increasing role of alumni who are investing their time, energy and resources to help the schools. Importantly, I also acknowledge the close association that the Embassy of the People's Republic of China has had with the two schools. And that's it. Thank you. May God bless the Yat-Shan schools and all their stakeholders. And may Almighty God continue to bless our beloved nation and all Fiji, all Fijians. Nazawalewu, Danyavad, Sukriya, Payaksha, thank you all.